Hi everyone, my name is Larissa. I am a neurobiologist and a person with Charcot-Marie-Tooth disease or CMT. Today I'm going to share with you my experience of going through anesthesia. Okay, let's go. In 2017, when I was already living in Japan, I had to make a difficult choice. My wisdom teeth kept being infected and inflamed, and so my dentist told me that I should have them removed. All of them, all four wisdom teeth. Although only two teeth were problematic, they were on different sides. And so to avoid the uneven pressure when I am chewing, for example, the dentist recommended removing all of the wisdom teeth. So the choice I had to make was whether to get each of them removed one by one under local anesthesia, or to have all of them removed at once under general anesthesia. And back at that time, somehow it was very easy for me to make this decision. I decided not to prolong my sufferings and have all of the teeth removed at the same time. Yes, I imagine that it would probably be torture after all of the teeth are removed for a while, but at least I will not be extending my sufferings over weeks or maybe even months. By the way, watch my previous video on anesthesia to learn about different types of anesthesia, including local and general. So although I was not particularly scared of general anesthesia, I talked to my dental surgeon about the fact that I have CMT. He didn't know about this disease, as far as I remember. So he checked it out. And I also sent him the list of so-called toxic medications for people with CMT. He checked it out. He discussed it with the anesthesiologist, the anesthesia specialist. They chose the medications that are supposedly safe for me, and so I went under. Here is the list of medications that were given me during the surgery, and you might recognize some of them from my previous video on anesthesia. The first one is rocuronium. This is the main anesthetic agent. It's also known as neuromuscular blocker or muscle relaxant, and it is used in general anesthesia to facilitate tracheal intubation. The second one was bridion or bridion, I'm not sure how to pronounce that. This drug is used for the reversal of neuromuscular blockage, which is induced by rocuronium. The next one is ephedrine hydrochloride. It is a central nervous system stimulant that is used to prevent low blood pressure during anesthesia. I didn't even know that this drug was used. In fact, I didn't know which drugs were used until I decided to check the list before making this video. And the other two drugs were, one was for pain relieving. It's an acetaminophen, basically, and the other one is an antibacterial drug. So you might remember from my previous video that rocuronium should be used with caution, probably for people with CMT, because there might be a higher risk of respiratory paralysis in some people with CMT. But in any case, my surgery went well. I didn't have any complications. I just had to suffer for like a week or 10 days approximately after the surgery, because I was spitting blood literally and I was in like horrible pain. I couldn't eat normally, I couldn't live my life normally, I couldn't exercise, of course. So that was quite a torture, but I was pretty happy that the procedure went well, and in a week or so, I was done with all the sufferings. I don't have any wisdom teeth anymore. They don't bother me, so I'm happy. Now, I do want to talk about the toxic list of medications for people with CMT. Back then, in 2017, when my surgery was made, this list was a really long list. And it was composed of drugs ranging from statins, antibiotics, to cancer drugs, anti-cancer, anti-tumor drugs. And even then I was quite skeptical about this list, because how come it is such a long list? Who actually made this list? What is the evidence? Is there really a lot of evidence, enough evidence for each of these drugs saying that they are risky or more harmful for people with CMT than for healthy people. Particularly interesting point of this list for me was that there were risks evaluated. So there was a list of drugs that were high risk for people with CMT, moderate risk, undetermined risk, and so on. So undetermined risk, I understand. But high risk, moderate risk, I was really skeptical that this data even exists. Once you start raising all these questions, it becomes clear that this list is kind of silly because we really don't have that much data. Maybe we do have some case studies on specific drugs. So case studies, as I mentioned already in my previous videos, are studies on just one person, right? So yeah, maybe there was a case study, a report on one person who experienced some adverse effect as a result of taking a specific drug, but this is not enough data to say that this drug is more risky or more harmful for people with CMT. And so my suspicions got confirmed actually in 2023 when a more rigorous approach was applied to evaluate this list. A group of researchers published a review of toxic medications in CMT, and they found evidence-based support for the statement that use of vincristine and possibly paclitaxel, both drugs are prescribed for cancer, can occasionally induce an atypical and more severe course of drug-related peripheral neurotoxicity in CMT patients. It is therefore reasonable to recommend caution in the use of these compounds in CMT patients. However, this is the most important part of this review, no convincing evidence for a similar recommendation could be found for all other drugs. And you know, CMTA made a very good job on having a lecture by the researchers who made this systematic review. You can watch, it's available on YouTube. The recording of the webinar is available on YouTube, and I do highly recommend to watch this video because it also explains why the peripheral nervous system might be more susceptible to neurotoxicity of drugs in general. And in this video, the researchers also cover that, yes, indeed, we don't really have that much data to say that this and this and this and this, like 100 drugs, are more harmful for people with CMT than for people without CMT. And again, I want to stress that I think this is really important to understand that only a subset of cancer drugs is known to be harmful, more harmful for people with CMT, the drugs that I've mentioned, and all other drugs are not considered, not known to have a specific neurotoxicity for people with CMT. So it is really important to understand that and not to be scared of these drugs, because some of these drugs, almost, or all of them, could be very helpful for your specific situation in a very specific context. So if you need an antibiotic that is in this list, you should probably take it and not be worried about side effects because of your CMT. Of course, there could be side effects, just like any drug and any substance almost can cause side effects. But we should not be particularly worried because we have CMT. We should just be worried the normal amount, just like healthy people are, that yes, a certain drug can cause side effects. At the same time, if you need to take a statin, for example, also, if you're worried, if you're avoiding this drug because of CMT, it is not the best approach. So, of course, no matter which drugs you are taking, you should be monitored by healthcare practitioners, especially if you are taking the drugs that are supposedly harmful for people with CMT, the ones that I mentioned, vincristine, for example. So even that drug, systematic review that showed that vincristine is particularly harmful for people with CMT, it does not mean that you should never take it. There could be situations where it is more beneficial for you to take it than not. even though we know that it might be more harmful for people with CMT than for healthy people. So each situation is very individual. It should be assessed by a healthcare practitioner. You should be monitored. It should be prescribed to you with caution, these drugs, but we should not be avoiding them, especially if we need them. So back to anesthesia. I also have experience of getting local anesthesia and being under sedation for such procedures as colonoscopy or gastroscopy. And I never experienced any problems during the procedure or after the procedure. And speaking of local anesthesia, I got it, I think, even several times because I needed stitches. Once I cut my hand, I was sleepy. I was chopping the bread with a bread knife and it slipped. I cut my hand, so I had to go and get stitches from the hospital. This can happen a lot to people with CMT because we are clumsy, we are less focused sometimes, we tend to drop things, we tend to cut ourselves, hurt ourselves more than normal people because we don't have such a fine control of our movements. And especially if we are tired or sleepy, we are more prone to do that. So in these situations, you might need stitches, you might need local anesthesia, and it's fine. You can get it. There is no data, no convincing data saying that local or other anesthesia is very dangerous for people with CMT. So again, I've reviewed the scientific evidence that we now have on local anesthesia, general anesthesia, regional anesthesia for people with CMT, and you should watch my previous video on that. But in this video, I am just sharing my personal experience. I understand that it's just one data point. It's not recommended to make conclusions based on just my personal story, but still, as an example, I can give you me, I can give you my experience of going through general anesthesia, local anesthesia, sedation, and everything went fine. So I hope this can reassure you, you can get anesthesia and you can get meds that you need. You don't need to be super vigilant, you don't need to be super scared or worried about taking medications because of your CMT. Okay, I hope this video was helpful. Please leave a comment below what you think about this list of drugs. And if you've changed your mind after my video, after the review that was made by the researchers and CMTA. Please like this video, subscribe. I really need your support. September is CMT Awareness Month or CMT Action Month. Everybody calls it differently. But anyway, in September, let's talk about CMT more than we usually do, even more. Let's tell everybody about our disease, share information. And please subscribe to my channel. Big news are coming up soon. I'm planning to devote more time, more effort to my channel, and I really need your support. Thank you. Bye-bye.